on a snowy Friday night in downtown Binghamton, New York. This is Danbury Hat Tricks Hockey, and it's live right here on the Hat Tricks Digital Network. Hello, Hat Tricks fans. Doug Letuca with you. We appreciate you for stopping by. Game one of three for the Hat Tricks this weekend, and the first of two here in Binghamton. The Hat Tricks and the Black Bears for the 16th time out of 18 this season. Binghamton has secured the top spot in the Empire Division with 107 points. Hat Tricks fighting for the second spot in the division. They are 5 points behind Motor City entering this weekend, and by the end of the weekend, they can jump the Rockers based on points, but Motor City not playing until next weekend. Well, we mentioned this is meeting 16 of 18 between the two teams, and the Hat Tricks struggled out of the gate against Binghamton. It was well documented throughout the first couple of months how Binghamton was just dominating the league, really, and had Danbury's number through the first seven games. The Hat Tricks had lost six of the first seven, and the only game that they won was on October 20th. First meeting between the teams, a 3-2 shootout victory for the Hat Tricks in Danbury. And at that time, it was Connor McCullum's first win. He'd stopped 51 of 53 shots. Shootout victory, and the Hat Tricks had a 2-1 record. That was three games into the season. Then the Hat Tricks dropped the next six to Binghamton and picked up just 1 point. 1 point is all that they scooped up against the Black Bears in the next six games. But then things started to turn. Once the calendar flipped from 23 to 24, the Hat Tricks found their groove. It was December 30th and the 31st. The 30th in Danbury, a 5-4 overtime win. Hat Tricks eking that one out. It was a Stoichevsky goal from the high slot that trickled through. Lavecchi, who was no longer on this Binghamton team, we actually just saw him with Elmira a couple weekends ago. Then the next night, the team traveled to Binghamton and also won past regulation. 4-3 in a shootout, a thriller on New Year's Eve, and a come-from-behind victory for the Hat Tricks, where they trailed late in the third period, surged back, and won it in a shootout. So that was back-to-back wins, and then the Hat Tricks followed it up about 2 weeks later on the 12th of January with a 5-4 shootout victory. So three consecutive wins for the Hat Tricks after losing six of the first seven against Binghamton. So the Hat Tricks thinking, all right, we've got the pieces in the right spot to solve this puzzle. Well, the last five have gone both ways. The Hat Tricks with two wins in the last five matchups. They do have points in three of the five games. The Hat Tricks have not been in Binghamton since January 19th. That was another comeback win for the Hat Tricks late in the third period. Harwell sneaking it inside the post, and then Cunningham with under a minute remaining went top shelf to win it 4-3 for the Hat Tricks. That was on January 19th. During that two-weekend span, the Hat Tricks and Black Bears played four consecutive games. Two in Danbury on the 12th and 13th, a shootout win and a regulation loss for the Hat Tricks, and then two in Binghamton, as we mentioned, the Cunningham late game winner on the 19th, and then a 6-2 loss here in Binghamton, the last time the Hat Tricks have played here at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Let's remind you, it is April 5th. That game was on January 20th. The two teams have seen each other since January 20th, though, on February 25th, and most recently on March 9th. And now we talk about that last game between the two teams back on March 9th. It was a 5-4 overtime win for the Hattricks. And Danbury in that game once led 4-2 about 5 minutes into the second period. But Binghamton stormed back. They got one in the second to make it a one-goal game. And the only goal in the third period to tie it up. And then the Hattricks, Daniel McKittrick out waiting. That was Nolan Egbert in net. He is the backup tonight for Binghamton. Outweighted Egbert, moving from the far circle to the near circle, wristed at home, 247 in, assists from Yao and LaBelle, and a winner for the Hattricks the last time these teams met. Now the Hattricks are just one, they have just one regulation win against Binghamton, and it was on the 19th of January. The other six, the other five wins have come in extra time. They have eight regulation losses against the Black Bears, most of those coming in the beginning of the year during the first seven meetings, as we spoke about a bit earlier, and then one loss after regulation. All right, it is time for the anthem here in Binghamton. Game one of two between the Hattricks and Black Bears. Beautifully done, and we are just about ready to go. Friday night hockey in snowy Binghamton, New York. The second to last game here inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena for the Hattricks. And the three of the final four games for Danbury against Binghamton starting tonight. The Black Bears come in struggling. They have dropped four of the last five and allowed four-plus goals in each of those losses. Prior to that skid, though, they'd rattled off wins in four straight and five of the previous six. Black Bears did take care of business back on Wednesday. They took down the River Sharks 7-3, scored two goals in the first 10 minutes, and then four power play goals in the second period, a 7-1 advantage after 40 minutes. They scored five power play goals overall in that game as they lead the league with the best power play in the FPHL at 28.6%. As for the Hattricks, they have not played since Friday. They thumped Watertown 7-4 in a dominant performance. Hattricks and Black Bears, 16th meeting out of 18 this season. And we are underway on a Friday night. Hattricks in the orange jerseys, black pants, orange socks. Black Bears in the black tops, black pants, and black socks with some green and white striping. Hattricks start the top line of Colby Johnson, Johnny Ruiz, and Daniel McKittrick with Xavier Abdella and Kyle Gonzalez on defense. Binghamton opened with its top line, Austin Thompson, Tyson Kirkby, and Blake Tosto. Dakota Bond and Daniel Stone are the defensemen. It's Connor McAdama against Connor McCullum in the nets. McAnatima did play on Wednesday, was 23 for 26 in their 7-3 win over the River Sharks, who are fighting for that final playoff spot in the Empire Division. As for McCollum, he last saw action on March 23rd in Withville. He was 27 for 29. That's a .931 save percentage. Also picked up his sixth assist on the season. He started now 12 of the last 17 games. A minute gone by, first period. Hattricks and Black Bears in the final stretch of the regular season. Gavin Yates, wrist shot snagged with the glove by McCollum. And no rebound for the 6-1 Ontario native. Connor McCollum has been switching off with Taylor Joseph. His much anticipated return to Binghamton will most likely happen tomorrow night. We've mentioned Joseph finished up the season with Binghamton last year, started all five of their playoff games, and was spectacular. We've went over the numbers countless times, and we'll do it again tomorrow when he is in the net. But started all three games against the Hattricks and was superb. Cunningham forces the turnover. It's swatted to the far corner. Bounces awkwardly off the boards. Cunningham sweeping at it, and it's controlled by Josh Fletcher, who flips it ahead for Don Oliveri. Zachary Pamelaine chasing after the puck, closed off along the boards. But the Hattricks sky it into the Binghamton zone. Nick DiNicola racing after Colin Fitzgerald. And Chase Harwell back centering that second line for the Hattricks with DiNicola and Cunningham. Shot from Johnson blocked, rebound, chopped off the side of the goal. Cunningham emerging, shoots, deflected wide. Ricochets off the end boards. Harwell gets there first. Angled it off the boards, and it's chipped into the seats for a stoppage. This game, 53 of 56 in the regular season for the Hattricks. Just four remaining, including tonight, and three of them against Binghamton. Twice here at Veterans Memorial Arena and once in Danbury. That's the season finale next Friday, the 12th. Hattricks finish up the year with two games at home. This Sunday, Elmira is in town, and as we mentioned, Binghamton on the 12th. Thompson shielded off the puck by Abdella, thrown on goal, save, rebound kicked out by McCollum, who had to be alert, trying to stick the puck aside. Awkward angle try, chested down by McCollum, and Ruiz connects with Gonzalez. His clear floats out of the zone, and Dan Weber recollects in the Binghamton zone. We've played 3 minutes, opening period, no score. Weber's wrist shot juggled momentarily, and then held on to by McCollum.
Don't forget to get your 50-50 raffle tickets at the Binghamton Hockey Booster Club table on the main concourse.
Mentioned off the top, the Hattricks are in search of the second playoff spot in the Empire Division. They have clinched the playoffs, and they do know their opponent. They will play Motor City in round one. We're just not sure where game one will be. Hattricks are five games behind the Rockers coming in. But Danbury, with two games in hand on Motor City, entering the weekend. Now, the Rockers do not play this weekend. Their last two games of the year are against Port Huron, a home-and-home next weekend. So by the end of things, the Rockers will have a game in hand on the Hattricks. But Danbury hoping that they take care of business and put themselves in a good spot. Here's Radcliffe, wrist shot over the crossbar, just past the mitt of McAnatima. And back down to center. McAnatima with just three regulation losses this season, one of them coming against the Hattricks. This is ninth start against Danbury. Yates tried to dangle through, was stopped by DiNicola. Harwell leads the rush. Drop for DiNicola, back for Harwell, snuffed out by Fitzgerald. And Yates zigzags out of trouble, surveys, and hands off for Smith. It's fumbled. Then popped in the air, Smith swatting down for it. In the area is Cam Clark, number 22. A couple of new names for Binghamton since the last time these teams met. A shot was stopped by McAnanima. The puck was lost by Fitzgerald, hopped his stick, and Cunningham was there. Almost made it 1-0, but McAnanima on top of his crease keeps it scoreless. Shots are 4-2 Binghamton. We've played just over 4 minutes. Top trio back on for the hat tricks. Johnny Ruiz, Daniel McKittrick, and Colby Johnson. Ruiz has points in 8 straight games. Had 2 assists on Friday against Watertown. Centering pass, McKittrick had his stick lifted. It wanders out to center, and Abdella goes cross ice. Chipped back in by Ruiz. He was just offsides. So a face-off placed outside the hat-trick zone at the near dot. Colby Johnson, 81 in orange, scooped up his first professional goal in that 7-4 victory over Watertown. Just 2 games with the hat-tricks and 4 points. He had a goal and an assist. Came over from the Macon Mayhem of the SPHL. One of those college contracts for the Hattricks. Him and Billy Berry have been sparks for this Hattricks team and regulars. Andrew Logar's shot block, rebound trickles on goal, and McCullum scoops it with the catching mitt.
In tonight's game, everyone in attendance will receive a free cheeseburger courtesy of our friends at Burger King.
Now, all season, Binghamton has really led the way in the Empire Division. They've already clinched the division title. They're a plus 96 goal differential, that's second in the league. They also have taken the second most penalties in the league, 1,405 penalties to be exact. Black Bears enter with the third best kill in the league. And we've talked about the Hattricks power play numbers have gotten better and better as the season has progressed. Ruiz picks the pocket, emerges, shoots wide. Bedard activates right point. Lost the handle, gets it back. Pass down low, snuffed out by Fitzgerald. He escapes. Johnson swept at him. Black Bears bench wanted a call. They don't get it. And Josh LaBelle turbos up the near side. Swipes it across for Bedard. In stride, chipped it, took a hit from Don Oliveri. And there's Liam Anderson behind the Binghamton goal. He's gone 5 straight games without a point. But against the Hattricks this year, just 2 assists in 14 games. He's transitioned from defense and forward throughout the season. His brother Jesse Anderson, number 77. Jacob Ratcliffe into the zone. Wrist one. McAnanima might have got a piece. A shot ramped off the stick of McAnanima with Harwell streaking in front. Ratcliffe pestering. It's scooped into the hat-trick zone, racing after it. Was Zach Pamelayan, pressured by Blake Tosto. Turned over at center to Tyson Kirkby, the Binghamton leader in goals, assists, and points. Their captain, very similar to what's happening in Danbury with Johnny Ruiz. First media timeout. About 6.5 erased. First period, Hattricks and Black Bears on a Friday night from Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. We'll be back.
Stop by TK's American Cafe on White Street in Danbury and try one of their 76 amazing wing flavors. Visit TK'sAmericanCafe.com for more information.
Danbury Parking Authority. Park in the Patriot Garage across the street from the Danbury Ice Arena. It's safe, secure, and legal. Make sure the only ticket you get is to the game.
Danbury Chiropractic and Wellness. Dr. Jared DiLorenzo is a proud member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Stop by and see them on North Street in downtown Danbury. Feeling good is an option, and they can get you there.
BuzzAid Appliance Scratch and Dent Outlet is the local leader for appliances and household wares. Do you like to eat? They have a refrigerator. Do you want clean clothes? They have a washer. They got it all. It's BuzzAid Appliance. Coca-Cola is the official beverage of the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Sweet, fizzy goodness. As refreshing as you remember.
We welcome you back inside Vision's Veterans Memorial Arena in downtown Binghamton, New York. 16th meeting of the season between the Hat-Tricks and Black Bears. We've played 6:25 in the opening period. The face-off to the right of Hat-Tricks starting netminder Connor McCollum. Black Bears have struggled as of late for a team that has dominated for the majority of the season. Binghamton has dropped four of the last five and has allowed four-plus goals in each of those losses. Binghamton did win its last game just 2 days ago on Wednesday in Elmira. And over the last 10 for Binghamton, they are 5-4-1. Hat-Tricks are 8-1-1. And they are surging, winners of six straight. That the longest active streak in the league. Across ice pass, Clark in stride up the left wing, shoots, stick save by McCollum, who was glued up against the post. Puck squirts to the corner. DiNicola harassed by Yates, looking for an option, and clanks it off the glass out to center. Anderson to his partner Fitzgerald. Cross ice, corralled by Smith, and he'll flip it in deep, where McCollum hands off for Gonzalez. McCollum with six assists, that leads all goaltenders in the league. Notched one in his last start in Withfield. Ruiz chips and chases, swats it off the back of the goal. Fitzgerald knocks it to the corner. Here's LaBelle right point, wrist shot, glove save McAnanima. And no rebound with Ruiz standing next side.
Extra premium hard cider, craft and transcendent, awe-inspiring liquid made and sealed right in Sydney, New York with New York State apples. Improve your day with
two teams haven't played each other in Binghamton since January 20th. A 6-2 Black Bears win. The night prior, the Hat-Tricks came from behind and won 4-3 in regulation. That was on the 19th. Two sides have seen each other two times after that, both in Danbury. An overtime win for the Hat-Tricks back on March 9th, and then prior to that, a 4-2 regulation loss on February 25th. McKittrick shoots it wide. Johnson follows up and snaps it. Bedard from the point. His wrister blocked by an ailing Fitzgerald. Inside, it hopped the stick of Billy Berry, who had three goals, first pro hat-trick on Friday in the win over Watertown. Berry with points in seven straight, 10 during that span, six of them are goals. And he's got four goals in his last two games. Billy Berry finished up his fifth season at Wilkes University and has centered the third line for the Hat-Tricks, with Ratcliffe and Woolley. Hamilton and Yao are the defensemen. Jared Yao was back in the lineup on Friday, had missed the previous six games, and actually extended his point streak to five straight, despite the gap. He had a four-game point streak and kept it going with an assist. Yao at the defensive blue line, has some room, skates over the Black Bears center ice logo. He'll shovel it in, chase after it, nearly caused a turnover, but Weber camped out behind the net as we approach the midway point, first period. Hat-Tricks and Black Bears no score, the shots even at six. Outlet pass off the stick of Logar. He gets crunched at center. Zinchenko shoots, save McAnanima. Zinchenko still has it. A late addition to the lineup. It was meant to be Michael Falanga. He's out with an illness. Pass inside for Cunningham. He could not control. Tried to go backhand forehand. It slid off of his blade. And Abdella at center ice. Floats it far side. Zinchenko's dump in. Blocked by Kirkby, who charges ahead.
Love down by Abdellah, who hands off Harwell. Harwell shoots, save, rebound. Steered to the far side by McAnanima. Harwell has it back. Below the goal line, a whistle, and the net is off, or an equipment issue for the goaltender, McAnanima. And as we are exactly 10 minutes in to period one, no score. Hattricks and Black Bears will take a break right here on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Coltec, the founder of Plastic Chamber Technology, is headquartered locally in Brookfield. Coltec is family-owned and operated with experience in the drainage industry dating back to the 1950s. When you're talking drainage and stormwater, Coltec is the world leader. Contact them today at Coltec.com.
Fairfield County Bank is the official bank of the Danbury Hattricks. It's where the Hattricks bank and the tellers wear the Danbury Hattricks top hat. Fairfield County Bank is your hometown bank and a proud supporter of your hometown team.
For a comfortable stay with great amenities, the only choice is the La Quinta by Wyndham in Danbury. Ask for the Hattricks friends and family rate. You can't beat it. La Quinta.
Texas Roadhouse, located on Newtown Road in Danbury, opened its doors locally in 2017 and is known for hand-cut steaks, cactus blossom, fall-off-the-bone ribs, made-from-scratch sides, and fresh-baked bread. The restaurant prides itself on its legendary food, legendary service, and legendary fun.
10 minutes to go, first period. Hattricks and Black Bears. Danbury with 8 shots, Binghamton with 6. No goals, getting past the netminders, Connor McAnanima and Connor McCullum. The face-off at the far circle, it's Yates and Ruiz. Hattricks with their top offensive line on. McKittrick and Johnson joining Ruiz with Abdellah and Gonzalez, the defensive pair. Abdellah shoots, deflected wide. Ruiz picks it up in the far corner. Angles it up top. Gonzalez, wrister. Glanced off of a leg and wide. It chipped up the boards by Clark. And Yates streaks right up the gut. Handing off. Deeking was Smith. Popped in the air. Yates chopping at it. Swing and a miss from Clark. It squirts out to the point. Bond head high shot over McCullum and off the end boards. Johnson with a hit in the corner. And that's a penalty, charging on Colby Johnson as he upended Clark. And the top power play in the FPHL gets its first crack. Mention the 5 power plays on 16 chances Wednesday against the River Sharks. They come in converting at about 29%. Patrick's on the kill, or fourth at about 81%, but they struggled on Friday, surrendering 3 power play goals to Watertown. Bond is the quarterback of the unit. A shot from the far side ricocheted wide. Kirkby had the opportunity. Bond kept it in at the blue line. His wrist shot into the glove of McCullum, and no rebound with Thompson standing in front. Now Johnson has to be careful. This just his third game. And the Hattricks need him to qualify for playoffs. He's got to play 5 games. So no suspensions the rest of the way for Johnson, or else his playoff eligibility is in question. Charging was the call. That's why he sits in the box for the next minute and 40 seconds. As Berry swats it down the ice. Harwell and Zinchenko hop on. Bedard and LaBelle are the D pair. Bond zips through center, drops off, returns it in the far corner. Kirkby, near side, ran into Zinchenko and Logar. And the puck was free. Thompson slides it. Harwell takes it. Clanks it off the glass and all the way down. With 8:30 remaining first period, 1 minute to go on the Johnson charging penalty. Hattricks against the Black Bears on the kill, 83% this season in 15 prior games. But they struggled on Friday against Watertown. Yates was hauled down by Abdella, whose stick was lodged. We play on. Ruiz gets there first and slides at the length. So the Black Bears have to go 200 feet, 25 ticks on the power play, under 8 left in the opening frame. Oliveri zigzagging through, gets past 3. Here's Oliveri, shot blocked. Kept alive at the left point by Yates. He walks middle, dishes off far side Stone. Oliveri winds, passes off, shot from Smith, blocked by LaBelle, who angles it off the boards all the way down. Johnson is free from the box, and the Hattricks survive 2 minutes over Binghamton power play. Black Bears did not register a shot on that power play. Hattricks doing a nice job blocking shots. Oliveri did knife through, but a block at the last minute prevented the chance. Yao at the left point, wrist shot, engulfed by McAnanima. He did drop the puck, but after the whistle. So he gets the benefit of the doubt on the faceoff to his right after the teams make some changes. Hattricks head coach Billy McCreary deploying his second line of Harwell, DiNicola, and Cunningham. Yao and Pamelain are the D pair. And the Hattricks will have some decisions to make come playoff time on who is in and who is out. Pamelain in a board battle with Kyle Stefan. They're still prying for it. Harwell emerges. The righty on his backhand had his stick lifted. Fletcher chugs the legs up the far side. Yao stole it away. Hattricks have numbers. DiNicola couldn't corral a bouncing puck. Fitzgerald stapled to the glass by DiNicola. And then Harwell finishes his check on Anderson behind the goal. Anderson gets it back. One of the alternate captains for Binghamton, pestered by Cunningham, and now has some real estate in front. Feeds it to center ice, and it's scooped in. And Johnson, first shift since the penalty. Finds McKittrick and cross ice for Yao. Right up the middle, hoping for Ruiz. It finds the Hattricks captain. Toe drag Ruiz. Pass down low through Johnson and Kirkby on the other end. 3-on-2 for the Black Bears. Kirkby to the far side. Wrist shot off the mask and covered by McCollum. Went off of his mask. Dropped down into the glove on the shot from Clark. Hattricks victorious in 6 straight and 13 of the past 16 games. That's 34 of a possible 48 points as they have stormed back in the standings to make it a race with Motor City. Mentioned their 6 straight wins, a current league high. But Binghamton has been somewhat of Danbury's kryptonite this year. Hattricks with just 1 regulation win against Binghamton. Came back on January 19th. Danbury has won 6 games out of the previous 15 against the Black Bears. Point shot wristed off of the blocker of McCollum. Thompson tangled up with Abdella. They battle for it. Thompson escapes, slides it up the boards. Anderson turned it over to Gonzalez, who gave it to Kirkby. Shot kicked out with the right pad by McCollum, and McKittrick feathers it off the boards. Johnson charging after the puck, and Anderson dishes off for his D partner, Weber. Dan Weber around Ratcliffe, leads Oliveri back for Weber, poked off of his stick, and Stone, who just hopped on off the bench. Headmans Oliveri, Binghamton in the midst of a change. Kirkby around LaBelle. Kirkby dangles middle. Couldn't get the shot off. Sticked away by McCollum. And Ratcliffe one-hands it out to center. And it's flung back in by Smith. Less than five to go, first period, no score. 19 combined shots, 10 for the Black Bears, 9 for the Hattricks. Woolley rims it in. Stone reverses for Smith, the forward below the goal line. As the Black Bears reorganize. Backlift pressures Yates. Did not play the last game. Yates weaves around Woolley. Far side, Yates slides it inside and through everyone. Zinchenko could not clear. Puck picked off by LaBelle. Up for Zinchenko. He lost the handle. And Bedard taps it for LaBelle. Not much puck possession for either of these teams. A lot of one-and-done opportunities. And both goalies have been sharp. But a lot of pinball being played at center. Black Bears enter the zone. Yates misconnects with Bond on a pass. DiNicola far side. Hattricks are making some major changes on the back end as Yao was right off the bench. Here's Ruiz. Slot, shoot, scores! Johnny Ruiz in the high slot. Uncontested. And he roofs it for a 1-0 Hattricks lead. You can't give Johnny Ruiz that much room, and the Black Bears left him all alone right down Main Street. The Hattricks captain with points now in 9 straight games, 5 goals, 14 points during that span. His 9th goal and 21st point against the Black Bears, and this is his 16th game against the Empire Division rivals. And Johnny Ruiz continues to lead the offensive charge for the Hattricks, his team-high 35th goal and 69th point. And Danbury draws first blood here in Binghamton. Mentioned the Hattricks with 5 wins past regulation against Binghamton this season, and most of them coming from behind. But the Hattricks with a 1-0 lead, thanks to Johnny Ruiz and his team-high 35th goal of the season. It's 1-0 Hattricks, final 2:54 when we come back right here on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Diversified Printing Solutions in Danbury is the Hattricks' official printing partner. You want it printed? Call Tina and let them get it inked up for you. They could do it all. Locally owned and printed on paper from Connecticut trees.
Dr. Matt Hartsburg is an official member of the Danbury Hattricks medical team. Hartsburg Chiropractic is cutting-edge chiropractic care right here in your backyard. Check out Hartsburg Chiropractic and get on the road to a pain-free hockey season. Blue Light Electric is a proud sponsor of the Danbury Hattricks. Blue Light Electric happily provides service to all parts of Connecticut, performing high-quality electrical work for residential and commercial properties. Blue Light Electric is always accepting new customers.
Litchfield Distillery. It's the spirit of hard work. The Batchers of Litchfield Distillery, in honor of the early farmers of Northwest Connecticut, present to you the locally made Litchfield Distillery bourbon, vodka, and gin. Grab a beverage at the Rabbit Hole and hoist the barrel with the Hattricks.
Doug Latuca back in downtown Binghamton. Hattricks on the board first. Johnny Ruiz with goal number 35 this season from Nick DiNicola and Bodin Zinchenko at 16:30. The Hattricks in front, scoring on their 11th shot. On goal, off the faceoff, a tie-up. Fitzgerald had his pocket picked. Berry poking for it. Radcliffe in there as well, but it's Thompson who comes away with it and reverses course. Anderson to Fitzgerald and the headband for Kirkby. Dishes off Oliveri, back for Kirkby. Woolley is all over him. Kirkby crashes into the boards. Puck slides towards the goal and McCollum gets the handle and stops play. So Ruiz now with points in 18 of his last 19 games. 32 points during that stretch, 17 goals.
He's done it all season, folks. Leads the hat tricks in mostly every offensive category. He has been dynamite all year. Shot from the right point. Raises off of a leg pad. Absorbed by Ratcliffe and up ahead for Berry. Zigzagging into the zone. Hands off Woolley. Fake the shot. Berry puts one on off the blocker of McAnanima. Squirts below the goal line. Weber and Ratcliffe tied up. Out to the left point, LaBelle. Across quickly, Bedard. Looking for a lane. Shoots wide. Woolley picks it up. Fires off the stick of McAnanima. Liam Anderson pressured by Ratcliffe. He turbos through center, floats one on. McCollum swatted it to the corner. Yates met by Harwell. Chugs the legs left side. Harwell takes it wide to the net. Harwell stopped by McAnanima with the left pad. Back for Harwell. Backhander kicked out. McAnanima with a couple of A-plus saves. Harwell in tight. Now, if you remember back to January 20th, as Yates dances in, drops off for Weber. And Yao planks it up the boards. It was Harwell who actually tied the game late in the third period, and he beat McAnanima just inside the post. Just a backhand flick.
1 minute remains in the first period.
And then Cunningham won the game. Under a minute left in the third. 4-3 for the hat tricks. Yates pressured by Ruiz, 45 ticks in the period. It's Cunningham out there with DiNicola. Floated for DiNicola, chested down by Bond, and the outlet for Yates. One-on-one with Abdella, drops off and a slap shot wide. Bond turns, shoots, swatted on goal. And the right pad of McCollum made the stop and a penalty. The hat trick stripping the call. So with 24 and 1/10 seconds remaining, Binghamton granted its second opportunity of the game. Abdella to the box for tripping at 19:36.
Choose flavor. Drink Henny Hard Seltzer. Your Black Bears are now entering the Henny Hard Seltzer Power Play.
Face off at the far circle. It is Kirkby and Ruiz. Captain on captain. Final 24 of the opening period. Black Bears 0 for 1 on the power play tonight. Kirkby wins it. Yates lost it to McKittrick. Off to the races. McKittrick up the right side. Shoot! Saved by McAnanima. Ruiz pinching in. Shoveled it below the goal line, but Oliveri is there. Final 10 seconds of the period. Smith leads Kirkby. Down low, Smith with 3 seconds. On goal save, rebound, pinballs around behind the net. Ruiz has it. And some pushing and shoving after the whistle. Yao involved with Kirkby. Kirkby, the most penalized player on this Binghamton team. With 113 pins. Yeah, rather, he's the second most penalized. The most penalized active player right now for Binghamton is JT Walters. Was suspended for abuse of an official on Wednesday. That's why he is not on the ice. One of the alternate captains for the Black Bears. But after one period of play, it's the hat tricks 1 and the Black Bears nothing. Shots finish off 16-12 in favor of Danbury. Just the start the hat tricks were hoping for. Now, we mentioned Binghamton is in a bit of a vulnerable spot, one that they have not been in really at all this season. They've lost 4 of the last 5 games, and defensively they have struggled. They've allowed 4 or more goals in all 4 of those losses. Now, for Binghamton, there's 2 games with the hat tricks tonight and tomorrow. Then they finish the season off in Watertown on Sunday. They're in Danbury next Friday night. That's the last hat tricks game and home game of the regular season. And they close things out here in Binghamton against the River Sharks, a team, as we've mentioned, that is fighting for that fourth and final playoff spot. And it's really going to be interesting down the stretch to see how these teams and how this standing situation works itself out. Because Elmira has four games left. Watertown has five. For Elmira, two of those four games against Watertown. And for the Wolves, they play Binghamton and then the Bobcats of Blue Ridge in the final two games of the regular season. We just saw the Bobcats. They're a gritty team, and they can surprise you. That's what they did to the Hattricks on the first night down in Wytheville. Hattricks did win the game in overtime, 2-1. But the Bobcats subdued the Danbury offense for about 55 minutes or so of that contest. The Hattricks finally broke through and got the job done. Want to take a look at some of the scores around the league thus far. The big matchup, of course, is Elmira and Watertown. In Watertown tonight. And the two teams after one period of play. Well, they have not started yet. I apologize. There are zeros on the clock for a reason. It's a 7:30 puck drop in Watertown. I should have known better. Come on now. We're what, 53 games into the season? Yeah, Watertown's a 7:30 start, especially on a Friday night. So those teams just getting underway. And that a matchup for fourth place and an opportunity to play Binghamton in round one. Watertown 3 points behind Elmira. And the Wolves with a game in hand. So a Watertown win tonight goes a long way because the Wolves would have one more game to play than Elmira to finish it off. And of course they play Blue Ridge in the last two games of the season. They do play each other tomorrow as well, Elmira and Watertown. So we're not too sure how much of the postseason conversation will be finalized by the end of the weekend, mostly because Motor City doesn't play this weekend. They have the full weekend off. Their last two games of the year, it's a home and home with Port Huron. They're at the Prowlers on the 12th, and then they host Port Huron on the 13th to finish off the season. So, Hattricks fans who are watching here tonight, don't make plans for Saturday night, April 13th, because there will be a lot of scoreboard watching. Most teams are in action that night, and the Hattricks are off. Their regular season will have ended by that point, and most teams will have games to play. That's what makes this weekend so crucial for the Hattricks. They can step in front of Motor City, but at the end of things, the Rockers will have a game in hand on the Hattricks, who play three times this weekend and currently have two games in hand on Motor City. It's t-shirt toss time here in Binghamton. They put about 13 and a half minutes on the clock here in the first intermission. Now, last I looked at it, they had the goal scored by Dina Cola, and that was not the case. The goal was scored by Ruiz. Yeah, they've got it fixed. All right, Ruiz with the goal. His team leading 35th of the year, and a team high 69 assists. Points in nine consecutive games, 14 during that span, and five of them our goals. Zinchenko with the assist, the late addition to the lineup. Now Michael Falanga made the trip down to Binghamton, fell ill right before warm-up, so he was removed from the lineup. Zinchenko, who had an assist on Friday against Watertown, slots in as the extra forward, and he now has points, 4 points in his last four games, two of which assists. And for Zinchenko, He's played 13 games against the Black Bears and has now 9 points, 5 assists for the rookie from Ukraine, 21-year-old. The hat tricks took the only 2 penalties of the period. Johnson for charging at 10:29. Hat tricks killed it off despite a couple of dangerous opportunities. And Abdella with the other penalty, tripping at 19:36. That leaves a minute 36 on the Binghamton power play right out of the locker room when we press play on period number 2. All right, about 11 minutes until period 2 is underway. Now, we've heard Colby Johnson's name a couple times tonight. The 6'3", 212-pound, 25-year-old just finished up his third season at Trinity Western University in the U Sports. Was with the Macon Mayhem of the SPHL. And recorded his first pro goal on Friday against Watertown. Has 4 points in his first 2 games. Well, we caught up with the rookie forward earlier this week. Here's how it went.
Colby Johnson, how are you doing today?
Oh, I'm doing great. How are you doing?
Good. So you've been here a week and a half.
Yeah.
On behalf of every fan, welcome to the team. Welcome to Danbury.
Hey, thank you. I'm happy to be here.
So this past weekend, you scored your first goal.
Yeah.
Right into it. How did it feel?
Oh, it was awesome. It was really easy. Johnny made a sick play. Tricky lifted his leg up too. Knew that play was coming. Just had to go down, put my stick down on the ice, and just tapping, you know.
You've been here for 2 games, one home, one away. In the span, you racked up 1 goal, 3 assists. What have you brought so far to the team, and what do you continue and hope to bring to the team?
Just energy, spark, presence on the ice, you know. Like that, if you mess around, you might have to find out, you know. I haven't had to fight anybody yet, but that's something that'll come at some point.
Definitely been able to learn that. Big fighter. Do you think that contributes to the way that you play, especially like size and because you're a winger and, you know, it all contributes, but how would you say that it does?
Well, I grew up watching Jerome McGinley, Wayne Simmons, Donald Brashear. Well, because they're like colored players in the Canadian market, right? And all the one thing they all had in common was that they fought. Donald Brashear didn't score as many goals. Maybe George Larocque scored more goals. Anson Carter, guys like that. I knew that fighting, you know, is something that sparks people, because like you're ready to go to war for the guy, for your guys, you know, whether it's like a spark in the, you're like you're up or you're down, like if you're trying to put the nail in the coffin or you're trying to, you know, bring the team back to life or just set a tone early, stick up for a teammate, you know, there's that kind of stuff. And I think that is just an intangible that I bring to my game to kind of give me some more space. I was kind of in a box doing that for a little while when I was 16, 17, 18. So then I guess like I built a history, you know, and now people don't really test me as much, but, you know, just knowing that it's there, you know, like maybe people won't be screwing around quite as much, you know. But.
Yeah, so definitely bringing those attributes and those skill set. Growing up, you played in the juniors, you played in WHL, you played in multiple leagues, came from the SPHL here. How has that transition been like to play almost all over, different leagues, different teams?
After a while, you know, the game stays the same. That's a big saying among the boys in every league. It's just, you know, X's and O's are similar. It's just, you know, sometimes the efficiency to get plays done more often, or you know, if you make a mistake, like people will, like in some leagues, like people will make you pay right away. But it's usually just team by team, right? Every league has its teams that you know, are just gonna make you pay every single time you make a mistake. Just with this league, I find there's more fans like into it. You know, U Sports, you can't really fight, so then. It's more student section stuff, and they're just there to get rowdy, you know, and pre-drink a little bit. Here, it's people are, you know, here to be entertained, right? You know, in all kinds of ways. So you never really know what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Puck drops. Yeah.
So winding it all the way back, growing up, small town in Saskatchewan, Canada.
Yeah.
How'd you even get into hockey when you were younger?
Well, my mom played. My dad, he's from Jamaica, so he didn't really play, but he was a fan of the game, fan of Patrick Waugh. I was living in Pinoca, Alberta, until I was 9, and that's in between Edmonton and Calgary. Calgary's captain, one of the best hockey players of all time, Jerome McGinley, and then Edmonton had guys like Anson Carter, George LaRocque, Greer, all kinds of guys who, looked like me. And my dad would be like, hey, like, watch that guy. You could be like that someday, right? And then we would go to WHL games, and the team in Red Deer right beside Pinoca, they won the Memorial Cup when I was there. And there was a guy named Colby Armstrong on the team. And my dad was like, hey, he's the same name as you, and he could do that. So there's ice all the time in these areas too, like in northern Saskatchewan where I moved to after. Like, it's cold most of the year, so there's nothing to do other than just go to the outdoor rink and just play the game, you know, just all day.
A lot of outdoors, yeah. A lot of hockey. You've mentioned Jerome McGinley a lot. Would you consider that to be your favorite player, or if not, you know, what is your favorite player? Do you have a favorite hockey team?
Jerome McGinley is my favorite player of all time. Yeah, for sure. Just what he did, playing with the Flames, and just watching him and hoping that he'd get his cup that he never did. But he's a Christian leader, and I think it's like pretty symbolic that he never got his cup, because he brought so much more to the game than just, you know, that accolade. He brought great leadership and a lot of passion, and he was a great role model, right? And he's a great shepherd, just for the game and for Christ as well. So he's probably my favorite player of all time, but my favorite player right now is probably Mikko Rantanen. He's the Moose is something else. So
you're more of a player's guy and less of a team kind of guy.
Abs are my favorite team too, but yeah, I like watching the Oilers play a lot. Vancouver's a lot of fun this year, since I live right outside of Vancouver now. Yeah.
So you said your dad's from Jamaica, your mom played hockey.
Yeah.
I noticed that you played for the Jamaican team
a
couple years ago. You want to talk about that experience?
Oh, it's awesome. I met some of the guys before in diversity not-for-profit for hockey called 43 Oak, and I met some of the guys there, and they were like, yeah, there's this Team Jamaica thing happening, and we're trying to get more people of just different descent involved in the game. And I didn't really know what to expect going into camp and stuff and playing with the team, but it was pretty awesome being around people who were, you know, look like me and stuff. But lots of the people, like, we have our citizenship in Jamaica, but come from New York, Toronto, Montreal, Vancouver, different places in Florida. So it was really cool seeing that interconnectedness and just seeing that there are guys playing NCAA Division I, U Sports, WHL, OHL. There's been guys playing in the NHL, AHL, and Liga overseas, like, all over. So seeing that there's guys that, you know, just like you, because in Saskatchewan, there's just not that many brothers. There's not that many East Indian people. There's not that many. There's not too much diversity, just because, you know, it's cold and they base themselves on agriculture, that kind of thing. So you can feel isolated and alone a lot of the time. So then seeing other people who are like that, you make good connections. And I talk to a lot of the guys almost every day. I'm talking to the coach tonight. You just learn that there is a network within the hockey world, and just seeing how small it is. And we won a championship out there, out in Florida the one year. I got the ring beside my bed. We were first team to win even though it was a lower division double IHF, we were still the first predominantly colored team to win anything in that side of hockey. So just need to get a rink now in Jamaica, even if it's a roller one. Yeah.
So you've showed what you can do on the ice.
Yeah.
What's something that you love to do or a favorite thing to do while you're off the ice?
I like playing guitar a lot. I play guitar every day. I like playing the drums and just music. I love to do that. Love to like ski as well. But yeah.
Favorite musician? Fishing?
Yeah.
Favorite musician, favorite kind of music?
I'm all over the place with music. Favorite musician? It's probably a band, Billy Talent from Canada. Grew up listening to them. They're a big hockey band. I don't know if they're big in the States.
I don't know, but I have to check them out now.
Yeah, they're a Canadian band, so I don't know if too many Americans would know them. But yeah, favorite type of music, probably like... listen to a lot of country these days, but probably like rock and rap, like that Linkin Park kind of stuff. Grew up on that, so yeah.
Well, I think for getting to know you, thank for letting our fans get to know you. Welcome to Danbury again, and thank you for your time.
Right on. Thank you very much.
What an incredible kid. Thanks so much to Colby Johnson for stopping by this week. A lot of insight on his game and some of the early success the 6'3 college rookie has had with the hat tricks. Mentioned his 4 points in his first two games. Was called for a charge in the first period. Hat tricks killed it off. They did survive. Now they've got to do it again against the top power play in the FBHL. Xavier Abdella is still in the penalty box for tripping. 1:36 remains on his penalty. The only goal of the game, Johnny Ruiz. What's new? Not a surprise. The hat trick's captain paces the team with 35 goals, rather. Corey Cunningham is behind him with 22, so 13 more goals for Johnny Ruiz and anybody on this hat tricks team. Was left all alone in the high slot and sniped it over the blocker of McAnanima to make it 1-0. The assist to Zinchenko. They took an assist away from Di Nicola on the goal. Shots after one were 16-12 in favor of the hat tricks. They possess a 1-0 lead. Danbury trying to make it 7 straight wins. Their 6 consecutive victories. Is currently the longest active stretch in the league. And we are underway in period number 2. Teams flip sides. Hat tricks are moving right to left in the orange jerseys. Black Bears will be wearing the Binghamton Whalers jerseys tomorrow night, their Hall of Fame night. Should be an exciting night in Danbury, rather in Binghamton. Wow, we are a lot of similarities with the Whalers has me thinking we are in Danbury. We are not. We are in Binghamton inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. And ice on the Black Bears. 41 seconds in to the second period. 56 ticks remain on the Abdella penalty. Four games remaining for the hat tricks, including tonight, three of which against the Black Bears. Tonight and tomorrow here in Binghamton, and then the season and home finale on April 12th. That's next Friday in Danbury. Sandwiched in between is a Sunday matinee with the Elmira River Sharks back in Danbury. Final skate with the hat tricks opportunity for all fans. It's the fourth and final post-game skate with the team. So grab your ticket, bring your skates, have some fun. 40 seconds on the Binghamton power play. Yates across for Smith, cross slot for Stone. Passes it up top. Oliveri, slap shot blocker saved by McCullum. Gonzalez had trouble with it. Located Yao, who bangs it off of the boards and all the way down. Where McAnanima settles, lofts out to the neutral zone. Touch pass from Clark to Stone. Toe drag around Berry. Stone centers. Yates shoots. Save. Rebound off the end boards. Stone to Oliveri. Walks middle. Return for Stone. Final 5 on the power play.
Stone drops off for Oliveri. Centers. Yates turns. Looking, drops off Smith. Has some room. Shoots, save. Rebound, score! With the power play expiring, the Black Bears slide it home. It's Cam Clark with his fourth goal of the season. And the equalizer, it's 1-1, early second period. Clark in just his sixth game with the Black Bears, fresh out of SUNY Morrisville State. He has now 4 points in his last four games, three goals, and one assist during that span. And not even 2 minutes into the middle period, the Black Bears have tied it. McCollum, Berry, all diving, trying to keep that puck out of the net, unsuccessful. And Binghamton, just as the power play finished up, levels this game at one. Stefan and Harwell twisting in the corner. Fletcher Rister snagged with the glove by McCollum. And the faceoff upcoming in the Hattricks defensive zone. The shot from the left point was directed on, stopped by McCollum, and then plopped right down with McCollum slightly out of the net. And an easy tap in for Clark, his fourth goal of the season. Kirkby wins the faceoff for Jesse Anderson. Rister off the chest of McCollum. And the lead for Johnson, steps over the line. Pass for McKittrick. Anderson snuffed it. Here's Johnson. Shoot, save. Johnson's got it back. Throws it through the middle off the near side boards. Johnson for Ruiz, picked off by Kirkby, who starts the charge. Oliveri up the right wing into the offensive zone. Back pass, Kirkby shoots. Hit the crossbar. Hattricks want a counter. Fling pass from McKittrick. Behind him, off the boards, and all the way down for an icing. Back and forth action. 2 minutes and 42 seconds in to period number two. And these teams have entered exchange chances. The post helping out McCollum and McAnanima was strong on the top of his crease as well on a couple of opportunities early on. Hattricks make some changes. Binghamton did so before the icing. Hattricks with Berry, Ratcliffe, and Woolley. Hamilane and Yao on the ice. It's Yates and Berry for the draw. Binghamton wins it. Weber at the left point. Floats it down low. Fletcher racing after it. Yates picked off by Woolley. Throws it to the middle. And Weber intercepts and backtracks in his zone in front of McAnanima. With Ratcliffe bearing down. Weber turned aside at the blue line. Yao. D to D, Pamelayan. Slips it for Woolley. Gave it away at center. It's touched in by Yates. Possession back to the Hattricks. Cross ice pass, Ratcliffe for Woolley. Knocked away by Bond, and Yao flings it back in. Tosto weaving through, stood up at the blue line, and it's sent all the way into the Binghamton zone. About 4 minutes erased, second period, and the Black Bears have tied the game on Cam Clark's fourth goal of the season at 1:41 of the period, assisted by Smith and Yates. Hattricks keep it at the right point. Bond reverses course. Stone racing after it, closed off. Pass inside, Harwell looking. Backhander off the post! He beat McAnanima, but not the iron. Hattricks had an in tight 2-on-1. DiNicola was open on the right side, but Harwell charged to the goal and flicked it off of the left post.
And we remain tied at one. Logar leads Clark, who ramps it in. Abdellah to Gonzalez, kisses it off the glass. Fitzgerald knocks it down with the mitt. Ruiz picks it off, but Clark, poking around, has possession. He'll loft it in. Hatrix have some room to operate. It's Abdellah up the left side. Chips and changes, but Johnson supporting. Johnson took a spill behind the net. And the Black Bears clear. Oliveri touches off for Fletcher. Play is offsides. And we've hit the first media timeout of period number two. Black Bears have tied the game. Clark at 141. It's 1-1. Early second period. We'll step aside on the Hatrix Digital Network.
Stony Hill Dental Care has served as the leader and preferred provider of dental care in Bethel, Connecticut. Go see Dr. K. He'll make you look like $1 million and feel like it too. The official team dentist of the Danbury Hatrix.
Vision Designs is the official merchandiser of the Danbury Hatrix. Vision Designs is a full-service screen printing, embroidery, signage, and promotional company locally owned and operated in Brookfield. Vision Designs is the hometown company with the national power. Check them out at visiondesignct.com.
Decker Tool Rental is the official full-service equipment rental shop of the Danbury Hatrix, providing a complete line of quality equipment to all types of contractors, tradesmen, and do-it-yourselfers. Visit them today at 84 Federal Road in Danbury or on the web at DeckerToolRental.com.
Kafala Coffee. Real coffee, good coffee, no, great coffee. Plus hot chocolate right on the concourse level at the Danbury Ice Arena. Kafala Coffee. Stay warm this winter. Early stages, second period. Binghamton has tied the game. Clark from Smith and Yates at 141. And a 1-1 game. Shots are even as well at 18 apiece. Doug Latuca with you. Friday Night Hockey from Binghamton, New York. First game of a two-game set here inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena before the Hatrix return home on Sunday. A matinee with the River Sharks. These teams see each other once again on next Friday, the 12th, final home game of the season for the Hatrix. Danbury will be scoreboard watching on the 13th for sure, with most other teams in action. Here's Yao shooting, it's Berry rather. His shot blocked and spits to the near side. Woolley looking for help. Lost the handle to Weber, outlet pass detected by Bedard at center, but it's picked up by Weber. Into the zone, self-pass off the board, spins off of Ratcliffe. Weber up top. Woolley was nearly off to the races. Liam Anderson, wrister trickles on goal, and McCullum's got it underneath the glove.
Danbury Hospital is proud to announce they are now offering urgent care visits from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Sundays, beginning April 7th. This service is open for both clients and non-clients alike. If your
Black Bears have stumbled down the stretch, losses in four of the last five. They did handle the River Sharks on Wednesday, just 2 days ago, a 7-3 win over Elmira. They scored five power play goals, four of them coming in the second period. As for the Hatrix, it's wins in six consecutive games, most recently on Friday, the 29th, over Watertown. McAnanima covers. 6:28 elapsed. Second period.
7-8-2-7-1.
Decent crowd here in Binghamton. Expecting a bit of a larger crowd tomorrow night for the Binghamton Hall of Fame game. They'll be wearing the Binghamton Whalers jerseys, former AHL team. We'll have all the history for you tomorrow. Puck drops at 7 o'clock, as it did tonight. And Danbury still in pursuit of that second spot in the Empire Division.
whereas Binghamton has already clinched the top spot in the Empire. They'll either play Elmira or Watertown. Hattrix are destined to play Motor City, just not sure where game one will be. Yates pushed out of the zone by Cunningham. Terrific job by the Hattrix rookie forward. Stickless forces Binghamton to touch up. Here's Yates splitting through, hauled down, wanted a call, doesn't get it. The other way, it's Harwell knifing in. Harwell on the backhand, stopped! Second chance, second time Harwell has been all alone within a couple feet of McAnanima. First time he hit the post, this one off the blocker of the Binghamton netminder. Touched off for Johnson, two on one. Ruiz shoots, hit the post, and it springs back near the blue line. So both captains connecting with the iron in period two, and we remain tied at one. Well, Hattricks with a bevy of opportunities in the last minute or so. McAnanima and the post saying no. 12 minutes to go, second period. Here's Clark, the goal scorer, ahead of the play. And the face-off. To the outside the Hattrick zone, right in front of the Binghamton bench. Johnson now after the whistle. Shoving with Stefan Anderson, got in there as well. He pushed Logar to the ice. Now we mentioned that Johnson is a feisty one, 6'3", 212, but he needs to qualify for playoffs to be eligible. This is third game, and the Hattrix with just four remaining, including tonight. He needs to get to five to be eligible, one of the college rules in the FPHL, so suspensions really hurt Johnson. He's got to be careful. Was not penalized on that play. It's still 5-on-5, 11:30 on the clock. Period two. Berry had a hat trick on Friday against Watertown. Woolley's stick exploded. Stefan floats it for Clark. Abdella angles for Gonzalez on the backhand, slides for Woolley through him, and the hat trick's control as DiNicola one-on-two into the offensive zone. Curls back, Harwell off the bench, slide pass form, picked off by Fitzgerald. Stefan up the right wing, outnumbered, and he'll slip it in deep where Bedard reverses for LaBelle. 11 minutes to go, second period. DiNicola knocks down an elevated pass. Ratcliffe keeps it moving. Weber shouldered him off, gets to the puck first. Weber camped out behind the net. Cunningham pestering him. Weber spins out of trouble. Backhand float through the middle. Kirkby for Weber. Into the offensive zone. Left wing. Wrist shot stopped. Cleared by LaBelle. Weber in pursuit. Cross slot pass. Tipped. Oliveri shoots off the chest of McCollum. Thompson off the boards to Weber. He walks, shoots, blocked. And the rebound to the far corner. Bedard, outlet pass off of a Black Bear. No icing. DiNicola and Liam Anderson tied up below the goal line. We've hit the midway point. Middle frame. Kirkby gliding through center. Cuts to the outside, or a shot into the glove of McCollum. No rebound, and immediate timeout here in Binghamton. 1-1, Hattrix and Black Bears' 16th meeting of the season out of 18. We'll step aside. You're watching Danbury Hattrix Hockey on the Hattrix Digital Network.
Clancy Moving and Relocation. Moving is stressful, but it doesn't have to be. Call Clancy and let them do the heavy lifting for you. Resident and commercial services, plus other services such as storage. Remember, Clancy is fancy.
Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury is the premier automobile partner in the Danbury area. Located on Newtown Road, the Bennett family has been putting the community behind the wheel for over 35 years. Dream big, drive a Maserati or Alfa Romeo. New and pre-owned vehicles available. Let Todd Maserati Alfa Romeo of Danbury be your choice.
Dowler Garage in New Preston specializes in batteries, brakes, and general service. When you're stuck, you're in luck. Call Mike so you don't need a bike. Dowler Garage.
Peach Wave of Bethel. Located on Greenwood Avenue in Bethel, Peach Wave is your place to go for a quality treat. Frozen yogurt and toppings, it doesn't get much better. Catch a wave, a peach one.
Welcome back inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Tie game 1-1. Hattricks and Black Bears. Doug Lazuka with you on a snowy Friday night from downtown Binghamton. First game of two between the sides this weekend. The Hattricks finishing off the remaining four games of the season with three games against the first place Black Bears. They led 1-0, scored the only goal in the first. Binghamton with the answer at 1:41 of this period has tied the game. Stone finds Fletcher. They play with it behind the net. Bond tied up with McKittrick, who's digging for it. Low to high, Pamelayan at the middle, wrist shot, stopped. Rebound, Johnson sweeping for it. McAnanima has it controlled as Stone tossed Johnson to the ice. He was off balance on the way down. Now Johnson has made himself a bit of a target tonight. Some clean hits, did have the charge in the first period, but has been mixing things up after the whistle. And has put himself on Binghamton's radar. Now, the Hattricks do have another big body they can deploy for tomorrow night in Riley Robertson. Has yet to play a game with the Hattricks this season, but was with Danbury last year. Big defenseman. He is not eligible for the postseason, but can certainly help the Hattricks get second place in the division. Hamalayan weaving through, touches it ahead, and is stopped by Stone. 2-on-1, Kirkby, right wing, toe drag, knocked away by Yao. His clear, keep at the right point by Anderson, across Fitzgerald, pass down low, tip, save McCollum, and the rebound, a scramble. Woolley gets there and starts the rush. Kirkby wanted a penalty, thought he was hauled down. Pamelayan, cross ice pass, Harwell gets there. Ratcliffe ripped down by Oliveri, and Oliveri's stick was flung along the glass. And after the whistle, Di Nicola and Oliveri exchanging pleasantries in front of the benches. Starting to get a little more chippy in this period. Faceoff in front of the Hattricks bench at the near dot. A couple dangerous opportunities. Pamelayan had actually deflected the pass from Fitzgerald as Kirkby was crashing the net. And then Pamelayan cleared the crease. Both 18s lined up together. Off the faceoff, had to be separated, and now Logar for Binghamton floats it in. Off the end boards, into the glove of McCollum. And the faceoff to the right of the Hattricks netminder. Somehow only 3 seconds went off the clock during that span. I'm not sure how that's possible, but nothing has been corrected, so face-off, won by the Hattricks. Abdellah angles it off the glass. Johnson swung and missed. Stefan plays back for Jesse Anderson. Lead pass ramped off of a stick. Should be an icing, and it is on Binghamton.
Fans, White Bears return to home ice tomorrow night for Hall of Fame night as they take on the Danbury Hattricks, donning the Binghamton Whaler jerseys.
One goal in the first, one goal here in the second. Hattricks striking first. Ruiz from Zinchenko. Binghamton getting on the board here in period two. Clark from Smith and Yates. Tie up off the faceoff. Fitzgerald curls back in the corner. Locates Jesse Anderson. Ruiz
picked off by Clark. Clark into the O-zone. Trailing was Logar, pass behind him. Ruiz wanted to go, puck hopped his stick. Stefan below the goal line, worked on by Gonzalez, centering try, nullified. Weber left boards, bounces off the check of McKittrick. Gonzalez, pass up the middle for McKittrick. Ruiz, left wing, looking, pass for Johnson. His stick was lifted by Weber. Johnson wanted a hooking call, didn't get it. Binghamton out the other way. LaBelle knocks the puck free. LaBelle up the right wing. LaBelle shoots, saved by McAnanima. He entered the zone with Berry. It's rainbow through center. And Bedard, pestered by Smith. Outlet for Ratcliffe. Touched on a Woolley. Ratcliffe, one-timer blocked by Liam Anderson. Black Bears the other way. Smith, 3-on-2 into the zone. His pass blocked towards the goal. Save McCollum. A scrum in front. Hattricks have the puck. It's Ratcliffe up the right wing. Inside for Woolley. He'll slip it behind the net. Hattricks back off. Have to make changes. Smith. Veers middle, hard pass detected. Smith has it back, waiting, shoots, blocked by Bedard on one knee. Zinchenko didn't have enough mustard on it. Bond blocked it. Bedard chipped it into the Binghamton zone. 6 minutes to go, second period, 1-1. DiNicola floating it for Harwell, chases after it, beats Bond to it. Zinchenko low left, picked off by Stone. Tosto and DiNicola met in the corner. Puck squirts into the middle. No icing called as the Black Bears cleared the zone. It's Pamelain parked behind the cage. Outlet for Yao up the middle. Deflected. And Kirkby flutters it in. Oliveri and Pamelain collide. Now Zinchenko and Kirkby battling. Kirkby hit hard by Harwell. That's a penalty. Let's see if there's any retaliation. Thompson and DiNicola. Officials got in there quickly. And the third power play for Binghamton upcoming. Hattricks have yet to go on the man advantage tonight. Now, I believe they're going to call kneeing on this or tripping. Because Kirkby tried to cut middle and Harwell didn't really connect much with the knee. It would be his left knee on Kirkby's more right thigh than anything, as the hit was more in the midsection of both guys than knee on knee. But either way, Binghamton back to the power play, top unit in the FPHL. Hattricks playing a dangerous game, giving Binghamton multiple opportunities on the power play. Remember, they scored 5 goals on Wednesday against Elmira. Bond shoots, save McCollum as he engulfs a point shot. 17 seconds off the power play. It's kneeing on Harwell at 14:35. Barry Ratcliffe, LaBelle, and Bedard are the penalty killers for the Hattricks. Logar for Kirkby. Near side, Bond. Wrist shot blocked by Bedard. Spits back out to Bond. Kirkby crisscrosses with Bond. Bond. Over to Logar, wrister, blocked by LaBelle, and it pops into the seats behind the goal, over the netting, and our final media timeout of the second period. 1-1 the score, still a minute 20 on the Harwell kneeing penalty when we come back right here on the Hattricks Digital Network.
Reverie Brewing Company is a featured beverage in the Danbury Ice Arena. Grab a Reverie and don't quit your daydream. When you drink Reverie, anything is possible.
Set Fitness is the official gym and training center of the Danbury Hat Tricks. Pump iron or tone up. Join Set Fitness and be the best you.
Mitchell, experience the difference. Mitchell has served the community since 1945. Heating oil, propane, and service for your home or business. Mitchell is ready to serve.
Oak Ridge Waste and Recycling has the roots in the community for all of your needs. Residential and commercial, Oak Ridge is the official sanitation partner of the Danbury Hat Tricks.
Hat City Physical Therapy is Danbury, Connecticut's leading provider of physical therapy and orthopedic specialists. Their highly skilled and caring team of licensed therapy providers are focused and committed to restoring your health and well-being so that you can return to the life you enjoy.
Back in Binghamton, Hattricks 1, Black Bears 1, 16th meeting out of 18 between the two teams, and the 17th matchup happening tomorrow, 7 o'clock puck drop here in Binghamton. An awkward kiss cam on the Vision's Veterans Memorial Arena Jumbotron. Some players getting a laugh out of it. And a back and forth contest. 4:45 to go in the middle period. Hattricks got the party started in the first period. Binghamton answered early in the second to tie the game. 1:15 on the Binghamton power play. Harwell in the box. Bond dishes off near side behind Kirkby. He corrals up top for Bond. Touch middle. Logar backhander blocked. He's got it to Kirkby at the right circle. Low to high. Bond over to Logar looking for a lane. Ruiz all over him. Out there with Zinchenko up top. Kirkby. Right circle. Pass down low, deflected to the far corner. Logar for Thompson off of his stick, swept it for Kirkby. Binghamton with 40 seconds to work with. Bond, wrist shot, blocked. Bond follows it up, bouncing puck in the slot towards the goal. Zinchenko whacking at it. It's available. Loose puck in front and out of the zone. All the way down, McAnanima plays it outside of the goal with 20 seconds remaining. McAnanima did play a little bit of forward earlier this season. With stick handling and lost it to Ratcliffe. Berry pries it free. Back for LaBelle, final 10 on the kill. Floated ahead, Stone gloved it down, enters the zone, and the power play is over. Hattricks a perfect 3-for-3 on the kill. Oliveri, pass down low, spinning shot stopped by McCollum as Clark was all alone net side. Almost identical to what happened following the kill early in the second period on the Binghamton first goal. That score coming right as the power play had expired for Binghamton. Shots are 27-21 Black Bears, and the score is knotted at 1. Yao had his stick swatted out of his hands. Oliveri comes away with it. Pass down low, touched into the middle. Pamelian stole it away and scooped it to center. Headman for Kirkby. Fluttered ahead, turned aside. Liam Anderson knocked off the puck by Ratcliffe. His backhander picked off. Thompson turns back in his own zone. Not much room near the blue lines for either of these teams to operate. Hattricks have numbers. Ratcliffe right side, a whistle. And they call a penalty on the Hattricks. They get Woolley for interference. Well, they might have both. Well, the Hattricks had possession of the puck.
For the Northeastern Striping Corporation, penalty kill.
Wait, the Hattricks had possession of the puck and they blew it dead. It was a 2-on-1. I believe they've called Liam Anderson for a trip. Now, him and Woolley collided at center ice, and once Anderson went down, he stuck out his left leg, resulting in the trip, but the Hattricks had a 2-on-1 into the offensive zone, and they blew it dead. It was a bouncing puck at center. Harwell collided with Anderson, who then stuck out his leg and tripped Woolley. Either way, the hat tricks to their first power play of the night. Binghamton 0 for 3 on the man advantage. The hat tricks enter with the 8th ranked power play in the league, but they've climbed the ranks throughout the season. Up to nearly 19% are the hat tricks. Power play goals in 14 of the last 17. They were 0 for 6 against Watertown. LaBelle has room. Shoots! Saved by McAnanima. Directs it to the near side. Ruiz to LaBelle. Across from McKittrick. Wrist shot stopped. Thompson on the backhand. Could not clear. It was touched with a glove. So a hand pass on the hat tricks. 1:22 left on the Danbury power play. Black Bears have won 3 of the last 5 with the hat tricks, but one of them coming and one of the losses, one of the wins for the hat tricks in overtime last time these teams met on March 9th. Second unit on the ice for the hat tricks. Woolley drops it for Pamelayan. Slithers through center. Hands off for Ratcliffe. Pamelayan opens up. Right point Ratcliffe. To Woolley. Returned for Ratcliffe. And over to Pamelayan. Jesse Anderson chasing him. Billy Berry slides it along the kick plate. Through Johnson. To Berry. 40 seconds on the power play. Anderson and Berry tied up. Johnson trying to knock it through. They wrestle for it. Out for Anderson, off the boards, all the way down. About a minute remaining in the period. 20 ticks on the power play. Woolley gains the line. Into the middle. Woolley nearly got untangled for a shot. Hattricks keep it alive. LaBelle for Woolley. Shoots. Stopped by McAnanima and no rebound. He's got it underneath his pad. And most likely one final faceoff on this power play with 45 seconds to go in period two. Off the faceoff, Binghamton rims it around, kept in by Yao. Zinchenko. Low left, Harwell. Back to even. Final 30 seconds of the frame. Rolling puck, settled by Yao. Backtracks in his zone. Outlet for Harwell, who starts the rush. Harwell, right side, shoots wide. Cunningham was crashing to the goal. Kirkby rims it around the boards into the hat trick zone. 10 seconds. Cunningham. Backhand float for Bedard. One last shot blocked by Bond. And that is it. 40 minutes in the books here at Visions Veterans Memorial Arena in downtown Binghamton. Plenty of offensive opportunities, but both goalies standing on their heads. 26 saves on 27 shots. For Connor McCollum, 22 saves on 23 shots for Connor McAnanima after one period of play. Both teams are 0 for on the power play. Binghamton 0 for 3, Hattricks 0 for 1. And the only goal of the period happened at 1:41 of the period. Cameron Clark from Connor Smith and Gavin Yates. Not even 2 minutes in. It was just as Xavier Abdella's carryover penalty from the first had expired. Just a tap in on the second opportunity for Clark, who now has 4 points in his last 4 games. One of the college rookies for this Binghamton team. Now, before we take a slight break for the intermission, Let's take a look at some of the scores around the Federal Prospects Hockey League. And in Watertown, after one, the River Sharks lead the Wolves 1-0. Dustin Gesso, the former hat trick, with the lone goal in the game at 1:47 of the first, assisted by Cody Rogers and Kyle Powell. The first period saw five penalties. Three on Elmira, two on Watertown, as those teams jockey for the final playoff spot in the Empire. Coming into tonight, Elmira with 57 points. Watertown with 54, but the Wolves do have a game in hand on the River Sharks. So for Elmira, it's almost crucial to come away with some sort of points, considering Watertown will play Blue Ridge the last two games of the regular season. And they also play each other tomorrow night, to Elmira and Watertown. Elsewhere around the league, the Columbus River Dragons lead 2-0 over the Blue Ridge Bobcats after one period, just about ready to start period two in Georgia. Justin McDonald and Austin Day with the goals. A minute and 45 seconds apart from each other at 102 and 247 on the first. And the River Dragons doing what they do best, which is handle lesser teams in the Continental. Now, Columbus has lost two in a row, but they're 7-2-1 in their last 10 games. First place in the Continental Division, 122 points. And somehow, they still have not locked up the division. Remarkable. Binghamton has done it in the Empire with 107 points. Other action in the FPHL, just one other game is underway. Now, there is another game on the schedule. We will take a look at it. It does not have stats as of now. I believe it's an 8:30 start. Either way, Mississippi with a 2-0 advantage over Carolina, as they are in the latter stages of the first period, about 2.5 minutes to go and ticking. It was Yuri Pestuka with Carolina's first goal at 4:30, assisted by Roman Kramer and Jan Salak. But then Mississippi at 5:27, not even a minute later, with the equalizer, Philip Wong from Matt Stoya and Jackson Bond. And that's where they stand as they approach the end of the first period. Now, the other game on the schedule is Baton Rouge and Port Huron. It's an 8:30 puck drop inside Raising Cane's River Center in Baton Rouge. The two teams meeting for the third time this season. Port Huron has won both of them, and both of the meetings coming in middle of November. The one team the hat tricks really want to have their eye on is Motor City. They don't play this weekend. Their final two regular season games are next weekend, a home-and-home set with the Prowlers, a Michigan mashup to finish off the regular campaign. Although the two teams are not in the same division, those two of the more important games of the season for Rockers and also for the hat tricks, who would love to control their own destiny, and they have 20 minutes to do it. Trying to grab 3 points and crawl within two of Motor City for the final playoff, the second spot in the Empire Division, which would grant them home ice advantage. Would mean game one would be at Big Boy Arena in Detroit, and then games two and three in Danbury. Hattricks also trying to keep their winning streak alive, want to push it to seven, which is the longest active streak in the league. Well, we played 40 minutes. 1-1 is the score, Hattricks and Black Bears. Another fun one here in Binghamton. First time we're back here since January 20th. It was a 6-2 loss for the Hattricks. But the night before, Danbury coming away with a 4-3 win. Binghamton has won 3 of the last 5 between the two teams, but the Hattricks victorious most recently on March 9th, 5-4 in overtime. McKittrick with the game winner a couple minutes in to the overtime period after Binghamton had scored 2 unanswered to tie the game. All right, folks, about 12 minutes until we start things up in the third period. We had a couple other interviews this week. Spoke to both Xavier Abdella and Jacob Ratcliffe. Let's take a listen, starting with the Hattricks defenseman, Abdella.
I'm with number 6, Xavier Abdella. X, how are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
Pretty good. All right, so you went to Wilkes University. How do you think that prepared you for the Fed?
I think Wilkes, as far as hockey, building great habits and just being a good hockey player, competing hard every day, and then outside of that, just being a good person. And I think that's something that that program prides itself on is growing men, and as far as away from the rink and not just on the ice.
So away from the rink, you were there for 4 years. You earned a degree. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah, I was there. I transferred from Stevenson University. I had my undergrad in marketing and then my MBA. So I was super thankful to have the opportunity to play hockey and get my degree there. So
as Herm likes to say, you have the most famous assist. Yeah. What was going through your mind during that game?
I think we were super confident the whole time. I think getting those 2 wins Friday, Saturday was huge for us. And then the whole game just trusting Gonzo, trusting my teammates. And in the last play, it's one of those moments you kind of black out and just play the game and let things come to you.
So speaking of Gonzo, he's finally returned. How do you feel being back with your D partner?
I love playing with Gonzo. We work super well together. It's super easy. Sometimes don't even have to talk, just kind of read off each other. So it makes both our lives easier.
So how are you preparing for the playoffs coming up?
Preparing for the playoffs, I think just doing all the right things away from the rink. Eating right, getting the right amount of rest, keeping things loose too, not just focusing on hockey. So, still hanging out with my friends outside the rink and, doing things I love.
So my next question is actually, who is your favorite person or people to hang with outside of the rink?
Feels like a bit of a loaded question. I'll slot Yao in there as my roommate. I'll slot you in there, hero. I'll put Gonzo, Raddy, Z, some of the guys that have been here around last year. I like MC and Stoge a lot. Those guys are good guys. But honestly, whoever I'm with, I have a good time. So I can't really pick one, anyone. Yeah.
Yeah. And one last question. You're known to have good style.
Yeah.
Where is your favorite place to shop?
Got to be a thrift store.
Yeah. Yes. You found any good ones in Danbury yet?
No. Honestly, the best ones in Wilkes-Barre that I find. So, or Brooklyn. Yeah.
Have to go back there.
Yes,
all
ma'am.
Right. Thank you.
Yep.
Do you like your grass green or do you want weeds? Yard Goats Landscaping and Construction services Fairfield and Litchfield County. Their specialties are tree service, excavation, patios, decks, and making your grass happy. Check out yardgoats.io and get green with the team.
I'm here with number 3, Jacob Ratcliffe. How are you doing today?
I'm doing great, Bella. How are you?
I'm great, thanks. When did you start playing hockey?
I started playing hockey when I was about 7 or 8 years old.
You're from New Zealand. How did you end up where you are today?
Yeah, I left home at a pretty young age when I was around 13, my first year of high school. Headed over to Canada, played there for a little bit, and then played juniors in college hockey up in Massachusetts, not too far from here. And then this is my second year playing pro, so yeah.
Can you describe what it's like being a part of the Hattricks team?
It's great. I mean, this is, a really special place to play, I think. And, it's like a family atmosphere here. So everyone's, everyone's really tight in that locker room. So it's a great place to play.
What are some things that you've learned while being on the team, on and off the ice?
On and off the ice. I think on the ice, I've just learned a lot about playing a pro style game. I think Billy does a really good job teaching that to kind of the forwards and the D, kind of little things to work on for your position to to kind of improve. And, you know, off the ice, I think I've definitely matured a lot as well, learning how to just take care of my body and, you know, be ready for kind of the grind of a long season that we have.
You recently came off of a month-long injury. How did you mentally prepare for your return?
You know, I was able to skate most of the time. It was an upper body injury, so I was able to kind of stay in shape. And, you know, I was really just excited to come back. And, yeah, I was just using that as kind of motivation and to keep working hard and looking forward to being able to get back out there on the ice with the guys.
In your first game back on March 1st, you finished the game against the Port Huron Prowlers in a shootout. How did it feel to lead the team to a win after being absent on the ice for that long?
Yeah, it definitely felt good, you know, after being out for a while to be able to, you know, come back and contribute a little bit in my first game. So that was exciting and something I was looking forward to. So that definitely felt good.
As we approach playoffs, what are you looking forward to the most and how are you preparing?
I mean, I'm just looking forward to, you know, playing here at the Danbury Arena in front of these fans. You know, they're always crazy, but playoffs is the next level. And obviously we're, you know, as a group, we're on the hunt to go back-to-back. So, you know, that's kind of why you play. These are the most fun situations to be in. So, yeah, I'm just excited.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks.
We'll be right back. I'm Zach.
I'm Jared. We're at the Rivery Brewery right now, helping them pack up some cans.
Yep, trying this beautiful specialty New England IPA you can get.
Hey, Zach, throw me a beer.
You got it, buddy.
Oh. I gotta catch those. I gotta work on my hands.
This guy.
Three points up for grabs. Hattricks and Black Bears tied at one after two periods of play. The third period just a couple minutes away inside Visions Veterans Memorial Arena. Hello again, Hattricks fans. Doug Latuca with you. An eventful first 40 minutes of play. Only two goals, but both teams have had quality opportunities in tight. Now, Connor McCullum has made 26 saves on 27 shots, whereas Connor McAnanima is 22 for 23 on hat-trick shots through 40 minutes of play. Black Bears have secured the division title of the Empire with 107 points. Hat-tricks could use these 3 points to close the gap with Motor City to just two. Rockers not in action this weekend. They are scoreboard watching. They finish off their regular season next weekend on Friday and Saturday, whereas the Hattricks play 3 games this weekend and just once next weekend on Friday night against these same Black Bears. Hattricks and Black Bears, 16th meeting out of 18. Matchup number 17 will happen tomorrow night, 7 o'clock puck drop here in Binghamton. It's Hall of Fame night, honoring the Binghamton Whalers, former AHL team. So we'll be sure to be on the air for those festivities for anyone interested. Black Bears will be in some specialty jerseys. Hattricks most likely in the orange tops, just like they're wearing tonight. Ruiz with the Hattricks goal in the first. Clark with the equalizer in the second. Final 20 minutes of regulation. Hattricks and Black Bears, another dogfight. Danbury moving left to right, as they did in the first period. And we are underway in the final frame. Colby Johnson tied up along the far side boards, engaged with Tyson Kirkby, and it's Dakota Bond backtracking in his zone with Ruiz on his hip. Stone angles it off the boards for Oliveri. Pass picked off by McKittrick. Headman looking for Johnson, but it was detected and then flung back in by the Black Bears with 30 ticks off the clock. McCullum was out of the goal. LaBelle escape from behind the net. Ratcliffe steps over the blue line, flutters it in. Berry chopping, was looking for Johnson, but it was knocked aside. Cross boards clear, bouncing. LaBelle couldn't get out of the zone. Johnson on the back check, clanks it off the boards. Ratcliffe scoops it through center, bouncing puck. Berry tried to poke it ahead, but Jesse Anderson recovered well. And a backhand sauce. Yates skate to stick, shouldered by LaBelle. And Woolley flips it off the glass and into the Binghamton zone. We've played a minute 15 in the third. Puck skitters behind the net. Batted down by Woolley. Berry sockers it ahead, but possession given to Binghamton. Fitzgerald plays with it in front of the Hattricks bench. Woolley, right up the middle, snaking his way through. Passes back Cunningham across. One-timer stopped! Harwell with a one-time slapper from the left side. And McAnanima chested it down and covered the rebound.
Fans, if you had too much to drink tonight,
Chase Harwell, first, in his 24th game as a Hattrick, has 17 points coming in. Points in 8 of the last 10. 6 goals during that spin. And he had
has 5 goals versus Binghamton this season, 2 of which coming in the most recent game on March 9th, a hat-tricks 5-4 shootout win. Almost broke the tie on that one-timer, but McAnanima with his 23rd save. Yeah, went down to block a shot. Hat-tricks clear the zone. Fletcher starts it back up. Knifing through center, flipped it on the backhand, went to Chase, was shouldered off by Harwell. Keeping at the right point by Liam Anderson, taken away by DiNicola, and he'll swipe it into the Binghamton end. Kirkby flings it cross ice, Weber overskated, Clark slips it in. Hamilton overskated, it gets stapled to the boards by Kirkby. But the hat-tricks possess McKittrick for DiNicola. Lofted for McKittrick, who's outnumbered below the goal line. There's 4 black jerseys in the area. Kirkby takes it. Another backhand sauce. Stone in stride. Centers off a skate. Left pad save McCollum with Thompson charging towards the goal. Here's Johnson chugging the legs left side. Dances inside. Johnson shoots and a save by McAnanima. With the left pad. Johnson looking for his second goal in as many games. Already has 4 points in his first 2 games as a hat trick. And a freight train crashing to the goal. Nearly put the hat tricks in front. Oliveri dangles near the line offsides. And a stoppage. 3 minutes and 25 seconds in to the third period. 1-1 the score. Only 2 goals in this game. 1 for the hat tricks in the first, and 1 very early on in the second for the Black Bears. Hat tricks trying to extend their winning streak to 7. Woolley up the left wing. Held up by Jesse Anderson. Nothing called. We play on. Ratcliffe, low to high, Bedard, wrist shot, deflected wide. Woolley slides it in front, and Jesse Anderson cleared it momentarily, and on a second effort, it wanders out to center. Ratcliffe spinning in front of the bench, dropped off for Berry. It was stolen away by Tosto. And Tosto lunging, locates Kirkby, back pass, the shot from Stefan blocked by LaBelle. Fitzgerald D-to-D with Jesse Anderson. Both teams making partial changes. Fitzgerald streaking up the right side. LaBelle steps up and slings it off the near boards. A turnover. DiNicola dancing, taken down, shoots. Fanned on the shot as Stefan got back. A shot by Yao, flutters wide. Pamelayan spins, fires wide. Yao activates from the left point, rims it around, too far for DiNicola, out to the right point, Pamelayan keeps. Wrist shot, glove down by Cunningham, Yates the other way, but Pamelayan sweeps it across, hat-tricks quick through the neutral zone, Cunningham steps over the blue line. Bangs it off the end boards, and Yates softly receives off the boards, gets the red line, and then gets a change. More than 5 minutes erased. Period 3. 1-1. Pamelayan off the glass. Johnson lumberjacks it in. Weber pressured by Ruiz. Johnson supporting as well. Wheeled around to Clark. Headman Logar at the red line. Stood up by Gonzalez. It's kicked by Clark in the playoff sides. 5:29. Gone by third period. We're at the first media timeout in a 1-1 game. We're step aside here on the Hat-tricks Digital Network.
O Plumbing offers a full range of commercial and residential services. Their team can assist you in all aspects of any plumbing-related needs you have. You have hope with O Plumbing.
Kellogg Hardwood Lumber, located in Bethel, has the hardwoods for any project. They are a kiln-dried hardwood lumber yard and manufacturing facility carrying the highest quality hardwoods available. Flooring, moldings, cabinets, furniture, or whatever you are building, they have the kiln-dried hardwoods you need.
Since 1881, Omaha Beef Company has been supplying the Danbury community with meat and beef. Located on Maple Avenue, they are now the featured product in the Danbury Ice Arena. When you say Omaha Beef Company, you mean top of the line.
Bold Move Logistics is a family-owned and operated delivery service provider exclusively for Amazon. As a team, they deliver packages the last mile to your doorstep. Check them out on the concourse level at the Danbury Arena and inquire about joining their team.
Back in Binghamton, a dance party in the stands, and a dogfight on the ice. 1-1, Hattricks and Black Bears. About 5.5 off the clock, third period. Hattricks opened the scoring in the first period. Ruiz from Zinchenko at 16:30. Black Bears evened it up early in period two, 1:41 to be exact. Clark from Smith and Yates, no goals since. Ruiz thought he got a piece, he did not, and an icing called right off the faceoff on the Hattricks. Sends the draw back into the Danbury zone. Shots are fairly even, 27-25 in favor of Binghamton. Black Bears won six of the first seven between the two teams, then the Hattricks won three straight. Shot off the faceoff, whistled over the goal. Oliveri was camped out at the ring of the right circle. Hattricks had won three in a row, and now Binghamton has taken three of the last five between the two teams, including tonight, three more meetings. Oliveri inside Kirkby, forcing his way towards the goal. Gonzalez tied him up. They wrestle for it. Pass to the back all the way to the neutral zone. Liam Anderson for Oliveri. Touched for Kirkby, offsides. For travel reasons, the number two seed will play at the number three seed in round number one of the playoffs. That's why home ice advantage for the Hattricks would mean game one in Detroit and games two and three in Danbury. That's just how things work in the FPHL. Typically, you'd play game one at the better seed, game two at the worst seed, and then game three, if needed, would be back at the number two seed in the case of the Hattricks. But Danbury still has some work to do. They're 5 points behind Motor City. They can cut that down to two with a regulation win. They can cut it to three with a victory past regulation. Face off at the near circle, Berry and Fletcher. Berry, Woolley, and Ratcliffe, the forwards for the Hattricks. Fletcher is out there with Logar and Clark for Binghamton. Berry pounces on the puck, dishes down low. Ratcliffe smeared along the glass. They battle to a side in the corner. Reinforcements on the outer ring. A scrum for it, squirts free. Then log jammed again, and Fletcher comes out of the pile. Backhand flip. Knocked down at center, LaBelle, tape to tape with Berry, poked off his stick by Fletcher. LaBelle turns it quickly for the Hattricks. Bedard for Ratcliffe, ramped it in. Danbury gets partial changes, and Binghamton has iced the puck.
Everybody clap your hands.
Hattricks with just four games remaining, three of which against these Black Bears. Tomorrow night, and April 12th, it's a Friday against Binghamton, and sandwiched in between the matinee with Elmira coming up on Sunday back in Danbury. Harwell, Zinchenko, and DiNicola, the forwards, with Yao and Pamelay. Another offensive zone draw. Hattricks won it, but out of the zone. Yao off the boards. DiNicola misconnected. And now the Hattricks have iced the puck. Danbury, of course, winners of the Commissioner's Cup last year, first time in franchise history, and just their second opportunity for the Commissioner's Cup. Now this season number four for the Hattricks in terms of playing, season five of operation, but Danbury, including this season, has only played in the playoffs three times due to COVID. DiNicola sent it across, knocked down by Smith. Leads Yates, who chipped it into the stands. And everyone appears to be okay, and a souvenir. I'd say that's 10 or 15 rows up. Everyone okay from the looks of it initially. Some clapping and some celebrating for a souvenir. Now, no team has ever gone back-to-back in the FHL or FBHL. The only team to appear in the finals three consecutive years. Another Danbury squad, the Whalers. They won once in three trips. Patrick's trying to get there for the second consecutive year. Ruiz, the Hattricks goal scorer, tapped it for McKittrick, kept it in on the line. Fitzgerald races after it, slides it in front for Kirkby, nearly turned it over, and Jesse Anderson at the controls for the Black Bears. Oliveri, far side, slips it near side, Kirkby winds, shoots, save with the glove by McCollum, and he holds on for the faceoff. Tyson Kirkby can sure shoot the puck. Tops the Black Bears in goals, assists, and points, as points in 16 of the last 17 coming in, and 16 points in 15 games against the Hattricks this season. So as Ruiz has dominated the Black Bears this season, which continued in the first period, Kirkby, the Black Bears captain, has done the same against the Hattricks. 11:30 left in regulation. Still tied at one. Chipped in by Tosto. Bedard closes off Anderson. Berry pirouettes in the corner. Has room. Fires up the gut. Too far for Cunningham. Play was offsides. Black Bears wanted an icing. They didn't get it. But Cunningham turned back to touch up. And Binghamton possesses in its own zone. Clark, the Black Bears goal scorer, over center, hands off for Yates. Dishes it down low. Bedard turned it over. Weber slapper. Right pad save. Clark cross slot feed was tipped into the netting with Yates on the other end looking for a one-time tap-in. Both teams 0 for on the power play. Binghamton 0 for 3, Hattricks 0 for 1. No goals since 1:41 of the second period. Near circle faceoff. Hattricks win it. Zinchenko with Woolley and Harwell. Fluttered on, steered aside by McAnanima. Miscommunication between Zinchenko and Woolley allows the Black Bears to clear, but Pamelain. He's back on defense for the Hattricks. Woolley cycling back, touched on to Harwell. Gets past Fletcher, chips it through Stone. Weber glides over, Zinchenko picking for it. He was knocked down from behind. And Weber floats it ahead. And it was bunted down by Yao. Puck flipped into the stands. So a stoppage.
CPR in downtown Binghamton. We got you.
Black Bears were looking for a breakaway for Clark. But Yao snuffed it out. Midway mark. Third period. 1-1. Johnson chips it for McKittrick. Low to High Gonzalez. Wrist shot stopped. Johnson was tossed in front of the net. He was looking for a second chance opportunity. Could not locate. Kirkby for Oliveri through the legs. Oliveri tied up.
with Gonzalez, who one-hands it to the left point. Bond keeps down low. Oliveri centers in the air all the way to the right point. Stone off the end boards. Ruiz for Johnson. Bond takes it. Tried a short pass for Thompson. Bond takes it back at the left point. His wrist shot blocked by McKittrick. He needs a change. And Bond sprints back for it. 9:10 to go. Period three. Oliveri and Abdella in a foot race. Feathered for LaBelle. Kirkby knocks it down. Kirkby around the net. Shoots, save with the paddle, and McCollum has it underneath. And after the whistle, Thompson wrestling with, I believe, Berry. Logar knocked the helmet off of Abdella. And the officials get in there and separate the two teams. Not the time to take a penalty. Yes, emotions are high, but in a 1-1 game, especially for the Hattricks where points mean everything, no reason to give Binghamton's top-ranked power play another opportunity. Now, both penalty boxes are open, but I believe we're at a media timeout on the ice. If there are penalties, we will get them to you after a break. You're watching Hattricks Hockey. The Hattricks Digital Network.
Charter Oak Brewing Company is a Connecticut-based brewery featuring handcrafted and innovative beers such as pale ales, lagers, India pale ales, brown ales, sours, and several seasonal, more robust beers. Pick one up at the Rabbit Hole.
Danbury Pace, Chipman, Mizuko, and Emerson is your partner for the road ahead. They provide comprehensive legal guidance for individuals, families, and businesses. CME. Let the pros handle your needs.
Domino's, the official pizza of the Danbury Hattricks. Thin crust, pepperoni, sausage, you name the topping, and they got it. Domino's, they deliver.
Partner with Fastenal to simplify and secure your supply chain needs. They handle a vast range of industrial products, and if you want it, they can get it. The core belief is in the people at Fastenal. They empower their teams to do great things for yours.
Grounds Donut House is the featured donut of the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by the main stand and grab yourself one of today's featured donuts. As good as it gets. Donut, miss out.
All level at one. 8:53 remaining. Third period. Offsetting penalties to Austin Thompson of Binghamton and Billy Berry of Danbury. Roughing at 11:07 on both of them. Black Bears playing an advertisement for their Binghamton Whalers night, which is tomorrow. Hattricks and Black Bears, 7 o'clock puck drop. It's their Hall of Fame night here inside Vision Veterans Memorial Arena. They'll be wearing the throwback uniforms. We'll have all the coverage for you prior to 7 p.m. right here on the Hattricks Digital Network. The task at hand, get the next goal. Under 9 to play. Third period, 1-1 game. Mamalayan launches the puck down the ice. Fitzgerald gave up possession to McKittrick. It squirts free. Yao shoots wide. Past the glove of McAnanima. 2-on-1 the other way. Kirkby with Fitzgerald. Kirkby across Fitzgerald. It was elevated. Tried to kick it down. Kirkby's got it back. Wheeling in the zone. Pressed down by McKittrick. Kirkby behind the back for Fitzgerald. It's Oliveri instead. Looking for a shot, puts one on, safe, rebound, score! Kirkby taps it home, breaks the tie. Black Bears lead it 2-1. Another dirty goal. McCollum on his backside. And Kirkby slid it into the open cage. So 4-on-4 hockey benefits Binghamton. And the Black Bears with their first lead of the night. Still 4-on-4 for another minute and 20. Hattricks with Ruiz, Ratcliffe, LaBelle, and Bedard on the ice.
Binghamton! Black Bears!
So Kirkby does it again for Binghamton. Team high 36th goal of the season.
Assisted by number 13, Don Olivier. And by number 15, Colin Fitzgerald.
Olivieri and Fitzgerald with the helpers.
Olivieri and Fitzgerald at 11:45 of the
11:45 of the third period. The shot's 33-27 Binghamton. And a one-goal lead for the Black Bears in game one of this two-game set. Hattricks in search of their seventh straight win. They need a goal to tie. They haven't scored since 16:30 of period one. Face off at the right circle. Kirkby beats Woolley on it. Now that's Yates, 12-on-12. Here's Liam Anderson knifing through. Hands off Yates on the backhand in front, kicked on goal. Probably would not have counted, but a save by McCullum nonetheless. Woolley the other way, turns back. Drops off Bedard, wrist shot deflected over the goal. LaBelle was parked in front. Bedard from a sharp angle off the chest of McAnanima. Anderson could not clear. LaBelle for Woolley. So Bedard shoots a snapper off the catching mitt of McAnanima. Zinchenko takes the puck away. His backhander nullified by Logar, who got back on defense. And Liam Anderson chugs out of the zone and then veers back with 7 minutes to go in regulation. Olivieri lost his stick to Abdella, who took the body. Harwell's lead pass knocked down by Kirkby. Harwell gave it away to Stone. Back to 5-on-5, both Thompson and Berry out of the box. Lead pass for Berry. Cross corner dump. Time not on the Hattrick side. They need a goal to tie. Stone angles it for Bond. Hattricks have backed off. Bond fires it ahead. Olivieri there. Shot stopped by McCullum with the glove. Olivieri did not get much on it, but McCullum makes the save, his 32nd of the night. And with that, McCullum has now faced 31 or more shots in 7 of his last 8 starts. It should be Taylor Joseph tomorrow in his 4th start as a hat trick. Joseph this season has a 233 goals against average, a 935 save percentage, and is 3-0 for the hat tricks since coming over in a trade with Columbus. Point shot, weaved its way through, sticked aside by McCullum. McKittrick, up the middle for Ruiz. Right wing Ruiz shoots, fought off by McAnanima. Kirkby dangles out of trouble at center, scoops it in to the right of McCullum. Pamelian gave it away, Fletcher, all alone, Fletcher shoots, blocked by Yao on one knee. Danbury the other way. Johnson into the middle, taken down, drew a penalty. Elbowing the call, and now extracurriculars. Johnson and Olivieri. Will they even this up? If they do, it would be a mistake by Johnson late in this game. He is not going to the box. Oh no. They're shoving him towards the sin bin. So Johnson drew a penalty, and then after the whistle went after Olivieri, and most likely evened things up. Now he cut middle and he took a hit up high. I mean, afterwards, they're both wrestling each other on the ground. I mean, yes, Johnson did initiate it, but Olivieri was still shoving as well. So they either even this up at 4s or the Hattricks are on the power play. Four on four in the faceoff. at the near circle. Ruiz, Cunningham, LaBelle, and Bedard, the four for the hat tricks. Binghamton wins the faceoff forward and all the way down. Johnson, 2 minutes for roughing. Oliveri, two for elbowing. Ruiz floats it in. McAnanima out of the net. Time continues to bleed off the clock. Under 5.5 to play. Fitzgerald, who assisted on the go-ahead goal, dances in. Fitzgerald shoots high. Rims around. Cunningham chips. LaBelle chasing, nearly stole it away, but Clark on the receiving end of an Anderson pass. Clark navigating through the legs of Clark. Chipped ahead by Jesse Anderson. Pamelain stops him. Yao up the left wing. Well, under five to go. Cunningham handcuffed. Clark the other way. One on three into the zone. Yates trailing behind. Clark to the net. Saved by McCollum. The puck's in the crease, and McCollum's got it underneath his glove. As we are at the final media timeout of regulation here in Binghamton. The Black Bears holding on to a 2-1 lead with 4:40 left. Don't go anywhere. The final 4 minutes and 40 seconds when we come back on the Hat Tricks Digital Network. Tixer is the official ticketing partner of the Danbury Hat Tricks and Danbury Ice Arena. Log on and get your seats today. Great service and easy to use.
Tri-State Legacy Group is an insurance group that focuses on putting your family needs first. Consult with them today and set your plan for the future. They care about people over products. It's that simple.
Twister's Ice Cream Cafe. Located in New Fairfield, Twister's features 32 different flavors of ice cream. This season, they are stationed in the Danbury Ice Arena. Stop by and visit their stand. Get sprinkled.
New Haven Nighthawk Brewing. Brewed right here in Connecticut and featured at the Rabbit Hole. New Haven Night Brewing Company is the beverage of choice at the Danbury Arena. Grab a cold one and party like you're in the Elm City.
It is go time for the Hat Tricks. They need the equalizer desperately. Trailing by one, Binghamton with the last two goals. The tying goal at 1:41 of the second. The go-ahead score at 11:47. Clark and Kirkby in that order. Hat Tricks haven't scored since 16:30 of the first period. Ruiz with a snipe from the high slot. 4-on-4 for the next 54 seconds. Oliveri and Johnson sit. Face off to the left of McCollum. Shots are 36-30 Binghamton. Back and forth affair. Black Bears with two gritty goals in tight have the lead. Ratcliffe paired with Harwell. It's Yao and Pamelain on the back end. Harwell into the zone, hat tricks offsides. The hat tricks winning streak in jeopardy, currently at 6. 5 points behind Motor City, with three games remaining after tonight for the Hat Tricks. Costo and Woolley collide below the goal line. Coming away with it, Pamelain. And Yao emerges from behind the net, zigzagging through center, tripped up by Yates. Nothing called. Oh, yes, there is. It was the back referee who made the call. A trip on Yates, and the Hat Tricks, who thought they had a power play on the Johnson interaction, he ended up taking a penalty after the whistle to even things up. Danbury now gets its second power play of the game. They are 0-for-1 thus far. Hat tricks were 0-for-6 against Watertown on Friday the 29th. a big spot to tie the game. It's a 4-on-3 power play for the next 5 seconds. Ruiz, touched for McKittrick. For Ruiz, slap shot save, rebound over the stick of Harwell. Stone rims it around, Oliveri and Johnson out of the box. It's 5-on-4 for 140. Hattricks trailing by one. 3:30 to go in regulation. McKittrick storms into the zone. Feathers it for Harwell. Curls in the left corner. Up top, Ruiz. Low right, Cunningham. Back for Ruiz. Sauced for McKittrick. Straight away, LaBelle. Ruiz winds, fires high. Wheeled around, glove down by McKittrick. A minute 10 to work with. LaBelle shoots wide. Ruiz pounces on it. Left point, LaBelle. Crisscrosses with Ruiz. Shoots, deflected wide. Rebound to the crease. McAnanima's down. The puck to the far corner. Bond clears. 2nd unit on for the Hattricks. 45 ticks on the power play. Woolley. Outlet for Ratcliffe. Back for Woolley. Nearly gave it away to Fletcher. Instead, it's Yao backtracking in his zone. 30 seconds on the 5-on-4. Ratcliffe and Yao. Woolley couldn't keep. Fletcher chasing after it. Reverses course. Fitzgerald sails it down. Final 15 seconds on the power play. And we're approaching 2 minutes to go in the third. Berry for Woolley. Back to Berry, snuffed out by Anderson. Power play is over. Back to 5-on-5. Ratcliffe for LaBelle. Shoot, save. Rebound spits out over the stick of LaBelle. Nearly kept in by Ratcliffe. But Stefan got it as far as center. Net is empty for the Hattricks. Extra skater on, trailing by one. LaBelle. Skate to stick, DiNicola into the zone. Ruiz back for LaBelle. Settles down at the left point. Wrist shot flutters through. Goes wide. 4 orange jerseys in the corner. 2 black jerseys. Hattricks pry it free. LaBelle. Back down low. McKittrick. To Ruiz with 1:10. Ruiz inside. Harwell blocked by Fitzgerald. The puck's in his skates. Harwell's helmet came off. He has to get off the ice. Anderson charging ahead. Ruiz for McKittrick. Right side, McKittrick. Pass in front, tipped wide. Rebound swatted at off the end boards. Here's Jesse Anderson with 50. Empty net. Kirkby shoots. Blocked by LaBelle. Off the boards. Sliding towards the goal. Thompson couldn't corral. Johnson with 40 seconds. Toe dragging, extra skater on for the Hattricks. Turnover, Kirkby shot it wide. Thompson and Yao. Thompson shoots it wide, got shoved down. 30 ticks to go in regulation. Hattricks need a goal and a penalty. Hattricks putting on the pressure. Binghamton sustaining it. And Yao to the box.
Cheese flavor, drink Hitty Hard Seltzer. Your Black Bears are now entering the Hitty Hard Seltzer power play.
Timeout, Danbury, cross check on Yao. He is in the box at 19:34. So for the Hattricks, win the faceoff, get possession. Get out of the zone, send McCollum to the bench, and then go to work. 5-on-5, try to get the game-tying goal. Only 26 seconds to do so. Hattricks were surging around the crease, but could not find the back of the net. Patrick scored once in the first. Binghamton with the last 2 goals early in the second, midway through the third. They've got the lead. Game one of two between the two teams. 16th meeting out of 18 between the sides. Patrick's trying to keep their win streak alive and push it to seven. 26 seconds to do so. Black Bears are on the power play. Berry tied up with Fletcher. It spits out to the near side. Harwell chugs the legs. Harwell with 10 seconds. McCollum to the bench. LaBelle into the zone with five. To the net. McAnanima steers it away. Ratcliffe inside. Ruiz shoots wide. LaBelle shot it over the goal and the game is over. Oh, Ruiz with 2 seconds reared back and blasted it wide. And Binghamton survives. What a game. What a finish. Only 3 goals scored. And the Black Bears with the last two to come from behind after the hat tricks entered the second period with a 1-0 lead. And the hat tricks come away with no points in the first game of the weekend. Heartbreaking for Danbury. But they're back at it tomorrow night. Hat-tricks and Black Bears will conclude the weekend set tomorrow here in Binghamton. And that will finish off the road games for Danbury this season. They'll return home on Sunday against Elmira and then Friday against these same Black Bears in the regular season finale. An exciting game to say the least. Not much goal scoring, but the Black Bears do just enough, as they've done all season, to edge out a victory. So, the hat tricks with the loss fall to 29, 18, and 5, 83 points. Still third of the Empire and still 5 points back of Motor City with a game in hand on the Rockers. Black Bears improved to 35, 10, and 7 with 110 points. They've already clinched the Empire Division. They will play either Elmira or Watertown in round one of the playoffs. Some updates around the league before we say goodbye. Elmira stomping Watertown, 6-1 the score. So the River Sharks will enhance their lead in the standings to 6. And both of those teams play each other tomorrow night. All right, all 3 stars go to the Black Bears. Binghamton wins it 2-1. That just about does it for us here on the Hat Tricks Digital Network. We want to thank everybody who's working hard behind the scenes. We want to thank you guys for tuning in to a road game on a Friday night. We'd love to have you back tomorrow as the Hat Tricks go for the weekend split against the Black Bears and 3 crucial points. 7 o'clock puck drop will be on the air a bit before that for some of Binghamton's Hall of Fame game festivities. All right, one more time, Black Bears 2 and the Hat Tricks 1. I'm Doug Latuca saying have a great rest of your night, Hat Tricks fans. And we will talk again tomorrow, 7 o'clock puck drop. Hat Tricks and Black Bears for the 17th time tomorrow. Should be fun. Have a good night, everybody. We'll see you tomorrow.